Hi, welcome to Ray's Toolbox. Today I'm going to put in a backup camera on the truck, and this particular camera also records just in case something happens. We should have a record of that. This camera is made by, if I pronounce it right, Fubedco. Don't know how you say that. F-E-B-E-D-O. This is a HD 1080p wired backup camera system. It has a 10-inch touch screen monitor. It comes with two wired rear view cameras. It has color and night vision, and it's for trucks, cars, vans, whatever you want to put it on, I guess. So let's unpack this and see what we have. So first, we have this box. Looks like it has the two cameras in it. They're all wired. I like the wired cameras compared to the wireless systems. I had a wireless camera on a previous vehicle, and it really didn't do too bad until it rained. And after it rained, moisture got in it, and it didn't work that well. Looks like we have a mount for the monitor, and then two lengths of cable. One of them is extra long to get to the back of a camper if you were pulling a camper or something like that. It says two backup cameras. I'm going to put one of the cameras pointing forward, and since it records, just in case something nasty happens, we should get both directions. It also doubles as a backup camera, I guess, comes on when the backup lights come on. So this is all your accessories. You can wire it direct, or you can plug it into the cigarette lighter. And then there's the mount for the monitor, and a few connections in the bottom. In this one we have the directions. How to put it together, tells you all about it, how to hook it up. The connections that go in the back of the monitor. And this is the monitor itself. Has a 7-inch screen. I believe it's a split screen. So let's see what we can do about setting this thing up. I made a template of the camera mounting bracket so I know where to drill the holes. To protect the cable under the truck, I ran it through some plastic flex tubing. It split down one side, made it easy to get the cable into the inside of it. Then I used black electrical tape to hold everything together. Then I used zip ties to run the cable alongside existing cables under the truck. I have a tray on the dash of the truck. It's a perfect spot for the forward facing camera. So everything's hooked up. I decided to mount it to the dash itself instead of the window. It's a temporary mount right now because I'm going to build a box around it and put a Garmin in with it, kind of make it look a little bit better. But right now I just have it plugged into the cigarette lighter. If we turn this on, you can wire it in direct. It's going to go through its setup process. And since everything is hooked up, it's going to go to the split screen already. It is touch sensitive screen, so I can just touch this one if I want the front camera, and it comes to the full screen. I can hit it again. I want the back camera, I'm just going to hit that one, and it's recording. Right now you can see the flashing red lights on both of them. If you want to change anything, we're going to go to, if there's a microphone we can put on it, let's go to the settings, and there's a list of things we can take care of. Record resolution, split time, microphone, mirror image for the back, split screen. We can format the camera, parking mode, time config, reversing lines, reversing display. It has an option where when you put it in reverse, the backup camera will come on, take over the whole screen. It has several other options on here. This particular system also has an option for two extra cameras, so you can have a quad screen on here. Let's get back. You can have a quad screen instead of two cameras, two screens. The other two cameras, of course, you can put where you like them. The other two cameras have a wire that you can hook up to the turn signals and mount them on the sides, and that way when you turn on your turn signal to turn left, turn right, your side camera will come on. That way you can see if somebody's behind you, if you're around them, that type of things. I hope this comes through on the video. The resolution on this is fantastic. It also has color at nighttime, which is really nice. That was an easy system to put together. It was ready to go. All we had to do was mount the cameras, run the wires, and plug it into the cigarette lighter. I'll get that wired in directly one of these days and make a box around it, mount a Garmin beside it, make it look a little bit nicer, I hope. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you on the next video. If you haven't subscribed yet, now's your chance. Thanks. Bye.